This video has been sponsored by Wondershare Filmora. Today we're having a look at some more of the most overplayed songs of all time. First up, we have Mood. Yes. You're always in a mood. I don't know what it is about this song, but it is hard to listen to so many times. Are you always in a mood? Around like you're brand new. I ain't trying to tell you what to do, but try to play cool. Baby, I ain't playing by your rules. I think it's just there's the same melodies over and over, over and over, over and over, and pretty much the same lyrics. It's a cool song. I really liked it when it came out, but I can't stand it anymore. Overplayed. Next up, we have Charlie Puth's song, Attention. Yeah, I guess it is overplayed quite a lot. I like this so much though. I know that dress is karma. The thing about Attention is that it's got so many interesting details that I, at least, start focusing in on stuff like the bass line that has all these little fun chromatic things in it, like here. All those little things are fun and you don't really notice them on the first listen. At least not me, because I listen to the melodies and whatever. Charlie Puth's lip smacks. But now when I listen to it, I hear stuff like how nice the voicings are in the electric piano or the bass line or whatever. I just want attention. You don't want my heart. Those little belts. Baby, you just hate the thought of me with someone new, honey. It's played a lot. I wouldn't say that it's overplayed because there's still things to enjoy in it. It doesn't make me go crazy, at least. Let me know in the comments if you feel differently. By the way, welcome back to another daily video. My name is Joel from Roomie Official. I make videos about music every single day. Here's a meme from the subreddit where you can also leave your memes if you want to. Yes, yes, indeed. Huh. Have you seen yours, Joel? His singing faces are so funny. Meanwhile, hey, this is a very normal singing face. I actually think I did this on purpose because I thought it was like hot or something. Like I look better just like
squinting a little bit singing.
Obviously did not. It did not work out for me. Me and John Mayer look like brothers here. Ugly, ugly brothers. Here we got Harry Styles' Watermelon Sugar. Huh. I don't know if I could ever go without watermelon sugar. This song has an annoying quality, I think. He has an amazing voice. It is an interesting song, but there's something about the melodies. It's very naggy. Just imagine your 8-year-old sister singing this to you. Like, there's something about it. Oh, I just realized you're eating watermelon in the song, and the song is called Watermelon Sugar. That's so smart. Big brain. I'm gonna put that one on not overplayed because even though it does kind of bother me a little bit how repetitive and kind of naggy it is, I haven't heard it that many times. I also wonder, where is it that a song gets overplayed now? Because people don't really listen to the radio. Where do we hear music? Let me know in the comments. Here we got Passenger and his song, Let Her Go. See you when you fall asleep. This was everywhere. I was so surprised this was never number one in the US. We talked about that in this video. You only need the light when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go. But yeah, I must have heard this song 200 times easily. And hearing someone singing the baby voice that many times, it's like,
you only make love when you're born, you know.
Yeah, that one goes in overplayed. That, as you probably expected, leads me into today's sponsor, Filmora. Wanna edit a video? I know where you should go to make your creativity just take flight. Filmora CC uses gold for newbies and for pros. It'll help you take your content to a new high. I just drag it and drop it. Drag, drag, drag it and drop it. Drag, 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 drag it and drop it. Watch me make it go slower. Make it look like it's snowing. Then I'll make it all blow up! Wondershare Filmora 10 includes tons of royalty-free music. Good for avoiding those copyright claims. Packed with features such as motion tracking, color matching, transitions, effects, and so much more. Try Wondershare Filmora 10 by clicking the link in the description. Keep in mind, the free trial will put a watermark on your videos. But listen closely now. If you write your thoughts about Wondershare Filmora 10 in the comments down below with the hashtag CreateWithFilmora or tweet me your video with Filmora 10, you will have a chance to win a 1-year license of Filmora 10. Now that is a good deal. Thanks to Wondershare Filmora for sponsoring this video. Come up
to me. Young Chris Martin. So weird. Looks like a deep fake.
Does he have something in his teeth? The quality is so low that I feel like it's a little piece of spinach or something, but it's probably just a gap in the teeth. He must be younger than I am right now in this. You think they did this on purpose to add a little bit of like freak appeal to him? They're like, ooh, there's a little bit of skin. Or was he just wearing a too small shirt?
Nobody said it was easy. It's such a shame.
All the classic music video tricks. He's lip syncing to a version of the song that is backwards. So therefore he can film walking forwards and like have people around also walking forwards. But when they sync it to the music, everything will go backwards. But yeah, that was definitely an overplayed song when I was a kid.
Pretty old song though, I have to say.
The following song is too fresh to be called overplayed, but considering how crazy people are going about it, it risks earning that status. Which song is this? It is Just For You by Lil Pitchy. Yes. No, I can see it. It's not overplayed yet, though. Stream Lil Pitchy's Just For You on Spotify.
That is beautiful.
Yeah, so, I mean, it's not overplayed yet. I think we should make it overplayed, though. Link in the description. Here we got Alan Walker and his song, Faded.
This is incredible. But yes, I'm gonna put it immediately on overplayed.
It's so interesting how he makes it work with this very slow tempo.
It's so sluggish.
But it kind of moves ahead somehow. It's all down to the production. It's just genius the way the drums move and the volume and the sidechain between the different instruments. It just works. Okay, next up we have DJ Snake's Let Me Love You featuring Justin Bieber. Dream, smoking mirrors keep us waiting on a miracle. I do not feel like this is overplayed personally. It's an incredible song, though. Really good Justin Bieber vocal take here. People always complain about his vocals, but this is great. Like, just a little details, like the vibrato on the second na. It would have been so easy to be like, don't you give up, na na na. But instead he's like, don't you give up, na na na. Just little details like that. He does it amazingly and with way more feeling than I did just now. Not to overplay it to me. Okay, here we got Oasis's Wonderwall. Today is gonna be the day that they're gonna throw it back to you. That version is not the overplayed version. The overplayed version is the terrible cover version the local douchebag did at the parties you went to in middle school and high school. Yes, overplayed, but not Oasis's fault necessarily. They were a cool band. Even looking back on it now, I think they're cool. And a lot of things from that era aren't cool anymore, so big ups to them. Here we got Imagine Dragons' song Radioactive. This was everywhere. It's amazing, but yes, definitely overplayed. Doesn't mean it's a bad song. Most overplayed songs are good, I would say. Let's skip the breathe out thing. That's like my favorite part. Okay, so here we got Cher's song, Believe. Yes, very overplayed. But before you were born, Gertrude, watching this video. Very, very overplayed back in the day. This would be like early 2000s, maybe in the 90s. When did this come out? 1998. Oh, here we have a song I've never heard of before. Israel is Kamakawiwole. And the song is Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Oh, yes, yes, yes. The Hawaii guy with the tiny ukulele. I think the reason this got very big was that he actually sadly passed away pretty soon after this was recorded, I think. Somewhere, and that made it a lot sadder. Over the rainbow, way up high. What a man.
What?
I'm gonna put it on not overplayed. It is a pretty overplayed song overall, maybe. But I mainly heard the version from the musical. If you've never heard that, that is a pretty crazy good song. This is one from Wizard of Oz. Somewhere
over the rainbow, so pretty.
It's funny, I read an interview with a guy who wrote this, and he said that one of his songwriter friends always make fun of him for this song, because the high note is on where, which is not really what the emphasis word should be. It just goes to show that sometimes breaking the normal songwriting rules will make a better song. I think that is genius, and I can't think of it like, somewhere over the rainbow. That makes it way more boring. Here we have Toto and their song Africa. Ooh, Damim.
They had no idea what they were doing here. They were making a timeless meme.
I hear the drums echoing tonight.
I wonder if they were dressing up as like Indiana Jones in this, and that was kind of what they were going for.
She's coming in 12:30.
He's sweaty. I like it. You gotta love a sweaty man. Yeah, I mean, after Never Gonna Give You Up, that is probably the song I've heard the most in my life. So it's gonna have to go on overplayed, even though it's still very listenable. It is a song that doesn't get annoying very easily. There's something soft about it. And here we have James Arthur's Say You Won't Let Go. Ooh, yes, this one is overplayed. He has an amazing voice. I really like it.
You made me feel as though I wasn't known.
I don't think his voice comes across that well in this song, though.
And you asked me to stay over. I said I already told you. I think that you should get some rest.
It's mainly the falsetto parts that bother me with this that make it so that it can be overplayed. It's just very like... There's also something about his voice that is a little bit put on that can get frustrating over time to listen to. He's got this thing he puts on everything. Here we got Shawn Mendes and Camila Cabello's Senorita. Yes. Oh, wow. This was everywhere.
We dance for hours in the same tequila sunrise. Her body fit right in my hands, la la la.
It's just something very jarring about listening to this many times. It is crazy good though.
I love it when you call.
Both their vocals are awesome on this.
I wish I could pretend I did.
Yeah, it goes on overplayed 100%. Did you guys know that they are dating in real life? You had no idea, right? Well, now you know. Here we have Spice Girls Wannabe. Oh, there's a lot of deep cuts. Old stuff in here. Amazing. It's just so silly and lame, and I love it. The way this got overplayed for me was that my sister would play it in the room next to mine for my whole upbringing. I've heard it too much. It must go on overplayed for me. I don't know about you guys. And here we have The Chainsmokers Closer featuring Halsey. Yes! How was this one not in the first installment of this series? What?
Hey, you tell your friends it was nice to meet them, but I hope I never see them again.
Yeah, this is probably one of the most overplayed songs, like, ever. Every YouTube cover artist covered this song. It was playing in the supermarket. Oh, that's probably why I have a hard time knowing what's getting overplayed now, is that I'm not in any public spaces. I don't go outside of my house. When am I supposed to be subjected to anyone else's music taste? But yeah, super overplayed. I heard this in Sainsbury's a lot, which is the grocery store in the UK. Here we have Maroon 5's This Love. This was on the radio all the time.
Sure, overplayed.
Young freaking Adam Levine. It's weird to see it. They're so skinny. He's kind of ripped now. Nowadays, I mean, but here he's like two sandwiches away from not having eaten anything. So he only ate two sandwiches for 20 years or whatever. That's my joke. I hope you liked it. Here we have Village People YMCA. Yes. I mean, yes, it's been played a lot, but it deserves it. And I'm not going to be here and say that it's overplayed. It's not overplayed, Phyllis. That's how you do it, right? How do you do it? YMCA. Is that... Someone told me that the Village People invented being gay, and I have to agree. It seems like that's what happened. I'm not gay myself, but, you know, if anyone would invent it, it would be them. Let's be real here. Here we have the Jackson 5 and their song ABC. It's hard to say that these classics are overplayed. It's not the first word I would think of. I would say I Want You Back is more overplayed than ABC. No, I'm not gonna say this is overplayed. It's so good though. Here we have Smash Mouth's song All Star. Okay, yes. Sure. Still amazing song, but it's going on the overplayed.
Hey now, you're an all star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
I forgot about this, but I actually probably heard this more than Never Gonna Give You Up. Let me know which meme song you guys think are the most overplayed in the comments. It's probably either this one or Never Gonna Give You Up. I can't make my mind up. Here we got Katy Perry and her song Firework.
Do you know that there's still a chance for you? Cause there's a spark in you. You just gotta ignite.
Yeah. The strings in this pre-chorus are
etched into my brain.
I know the exact sound. I know exactly what they're playing. That means that it's been overplayed because I haven't really sought out this song, but still, I know every little production detail.
Let it shine, just
these vocals are good though. I think this is Stargazer produced. This was actually one of the first times I read an interview with a producer and I was like, oh, these guys are lying. Because I think they said that there was no autotune or anything on her vocal in this song. And that's so clearly not true. You can really hear artifacts and a bunch of the things.
Come on, show them what you were. Make them go, as you shoot across the sky.
Like on the shoot across the sky, all that stuff. It doesn't sound natural 100%. And there's nothing wrong with autotune. I just don't like when people lie. That's the whole thing. Here we have The Weeknd and his song Blinding Lights. And yes, this is overplayed. Can't argue with that. Doesn't mean it's a bad song. I like the dance. He's a very swaggy boy. It's the type of dance you can see a toddler do, and I don't mean that in a bad way. He should make like The Weeknd Jr., a little person that looks like The Weeknd that can do all the dances and sing all the songs in a censored way. I think there's a big market for that. All the Christian people who complain about swearing in pop music. You can just have mini The Weeknd, mini Taylor Swift. Let's crowdfund this. Let's start the Kickstarter. And here we have Lil Nas X and his song Old Town Road. I'm like tired from seeing that name now. He did so many remixes and it was number one on the Billboard charts forever. Yes. Overplayed. However, his new song, Montero, very good.
Take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
For our next overplayed song, we have Jessie J, Ariana Grande, Nicki Minaj with their song Bang Bang. This is a cool song. It's like lacking bass and stuff. The drums are like Kajon or something. Listen to that.
Phone ringing, he's slanging.
So sick.
It ain't karaoke night, but get the mic cause I'm singing.
See anybody coming good sick. To you? You need a bag, gotta burn your mind,
okay.
Freaking Jessie J. Goosebumps immediately. Oh! That is unbelievable. I love that song so much. I want to put it in overplayed because it was everywhere, but I just enjoy it too much whenever it comes on. Can't find it in my heart to say anything negative about that song. Goes, I'm not overplayed. Okay, guys, we came for more music commentary videos. We came for music VS videos. And today we have 16 overplayed songs and 8 not overplayed songs. Let me know what you guys got in the comments down below. Now, if you'll go excuse me, I have a tiny The Weeknd to train and a tiny Taylor Swift to start dating tiny other boys so she can write tiny sad songs. Bye.